going on, Connecticut? Welcome to Chip's Unnamed Local Band Show. The show's so awesome, we didn't even bother coming up with a name for it. This episode, it's all about girl power, and I'm not talking about the Spice Girls. We're going to be meeting up with the front women of three of the best local bands Connecticut and the surrounding areas have to offer. So get your popcorn out, get your soda on, and keep it locked right here to CT. Connecticut, what's going on? We are down here in New Haven, right outside of Cafe 9, and we are about to go inside and see one of my favorite bands right now, Sarah Borges and the Broken Singles. Guess who I have standing next to me? Can you take a guess? Sarah Borges, how are you?
I'm good. I'm hot. It's hot out here in Connecticut.
It's like Africa hot today. It really is. So tell us about what's going on with Sarah Borges and the Broken Singles right now. You said you are on tour.
We just got back from tour, actually, on Monday. We were out for about 5.5 weeks, which is kind of long, living in this thing right here. Yep, very glamorous. But we just finished putting out a live record, and we have a live DVD coming out, too, very soon. So it's sort of a, not a hometown return, but Cafe 9, this is our 10th time here, so kind of a hometown return, and we're psyched to do it. We've been all over the country, but we look forward to coming back here.
New Haven's a great place to play, so is Cafe 9. Let's talk about the live DVD and the live CD, because those are self-produced, correct? You're putting those out on your own?
Yeah, both of them were audience-funded as well. So the live CD was something that was, you know, done by pre-orders. And the DVD was actually done entirely by donations from our fans, which is a humbling experience. People put up all kinds of money, more than the cost of purchasing the thing, and helped us get it done. So I think that's sort of a new wave amongst artists and musicians, is having audiences fund their work just because they feel closer to it, and so do their fans.
And quite telling that you actually have fans that would be willing to pony up extra cash for that.
You know, I was afraid no one would pay. It was a great idea in theory, but and organically speaking, but I was afraid no one would do it. So I was very happy when people started to chip in.
Awesome. Well, let's talk about the music. So all over the board with influences, how would you describe the music?
Usually just say we're an American rock band, with everything that encompasses. There's been a tradition in rock music of country, of blues, of everything else. So I know it's hard for people to, you know, want to hear something they can't get a handle on ahead of time. So we try to give an apt description, but we just say that hopefully we sound like your favorite person's record collection.
I like that. I like that a lot. Upcoming plans, new record in the works.
Yeah. We went to Portland, Oregon as part of the tour. We did some demos out there at a studio there. We did four, and we'll definitely play a couple of them at our show at the Cafe 9 tonight. And then, you know, we have plans to get in the studio this fall and start doing a whole nother record. We don't know where it's going to end up. It could be another fan-produced one. It could be a record label one. But that's sort of the good thing about how music is now, is you have complete freedom to do it how you want to.
That's a beautiful thing. How is the relationship with the record, I should say, Sugar Hill?
They've been really good to us. You know, they have a great history as a label. It's Sugar Hill and Vanguard. They're one company. It was started by Lawrence Welk. His entire family still continues to work there. And they're very generous with their time and their money. But just like anybody else, any other corporation, they're getting hit hard by the economy. So they don't have as much money to invest in artists who maybe aren't big money makers. You know, they have records by Dolly Parton or, you know, Nickel Creek, things like that.
You're saying you're not as big as Dolly? Seriously?
In which way?
You're coming back to Connecticut soon?
Yeah. September 24th, I think, and you should date check me, but Infinity Hall, which is such a beautiful venue.
It really is. Any parting words for us, for the fans out there?
You know, Connecticut is not that far from our hometown of Boston, but it's worlds away in terms of the commitment of the fans to live music. We get not as great a response in Boston, so we thank everyone very much, and keep on coming back, and bring 10 friends.
They need to relocate to Connecticut. All right, so right now, we're talking to Sarah Borges. We're talking about all the new stuff she has coming up. We're actually going to go off into a song off the last record, though, correct?
Yeah, the last studio record. It's a song called Do It For Free. It's off our record, The Stars Are Out.
Check it out.
Some kind of problem. Well, Lord knows I got mine.
Stay tuned, because coming up after the break, we're going to take it out to East Hartford to the Podunk Bluegrass Festival and meet up with Katie Wilson and the Two-Time String Band.